بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وبارك على اشرف الانبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اما بعد، الحمد لله. Today is supposed to discuss two narrations. One found in Sahih Muslim, one found in Sahih Bukhari. Or both found in Sahih Muslim. And actually a third one found in Sahih Bukhari. The first narration is a narration of Abi Umama radiallahu anhu. قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اقرأ القرآن فإنه يأتي اليوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. Narration Abi Umama mentions that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, recite from the Quran, for indeed it will come forth يوم القيامة to intercede for its people. This hadith is found in Sahih Muslim. You have the narration as well of Al-Nawas ibn Sam'an. قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول يؤتى اليوم القيامة بالقرآن وأهله الذين كانوا يعملون به في الدنيا تقدموا سورة البقرة وآل عمران تهاجان عن صاحبهما وروح مسلم. And a narration of Nawas and Sam'an, where he says, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that the Quran is brought forth yawm al-qiyamah, and it comes forth on behalf of its people, those that used to act upon it in the dunya. Surah al-Baqarah and Surah al-Imran come forth bearing witness or يعني its people, I know that recited it and acted upon it. Finally, the narration of Uthman ibn Affan رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه رواه البخاري. And the narration of Uthman ibn Affan, where he states that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the best of you are those that learn the Quran and teach it. So these three narrations, barakallahu feekum, all of them indicating the fadl, the benefit of being from Ahlul Quran, being from the people of Quran. Well, Ahlul Quran, the people of Quran, no doubt, are those that learn from the Quran, recite the Quran, but of course, along with that, act upon it. That they act upon it. And so their affair of the Book of Allah is not just one of recitation. Rather, they have iman بأنه كلام الله حق. The people of Quran, they have iman, they have belief that this, no doubt, is the speech of Allah in truth. منزل غير مخلوق, that it has been revealed and is not created. And so it's upon everyone from the Ummah to adhere to that, on the speech of Shaykh al-Baz, and that the individual has istiqamah, he is upright by way of his teachings. وهذا مما يخالفه. And that the person, he has a degree of caution in relation to the one that opposes it. And so his relationship with the Quran is one of no doubt acting upon it, and a relationship of opposing those who oppose it. For indeed, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in that first narration, the intercession. And the intercession for the one, those that act upon the Quran. And in the second narration, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the particular ayat or surahs that will bear witness for its people. Right? The individual that adheres to the particular surahs that his people, that indeed the people that will act upon those surahs, they will benefit from that. Therein. And all of these, both of these narrations here are indicative of the sharf, of the honor found within them, and the honor found for the one that acts upon them. Likewise, we have the narration of Uthman ibn Affan, where he mentioned, the best of you, those that learn the Quran and teach it. That he's a khiyar al-nas, he's the best of the people. And the best of the people, Ahlul Quran. The best of the people, the Quran. I know that learn it, and thus, after learning it, act upon it. And then that which follows, no doubt, that they teach it. And they teach it to the people. For we understand when the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mentions, teaching the Quran, then no doubt this occurs as a result of acting upon it. That the one does not merely learn it and then teach it, but he learns from it, acts upon it, takes heed of it, and then teaches it. For indeed we know knowledge, as mentioned by Imam Bukhari, al-ilm, qabla qawli wa amal. Knowledge receives speech and action. And so, these are the best of the people. The best of the people that learn from the Quran and thus teach it. After, of course, acting upon it. And the meaning here, as Sheikh Ibn Baz mentioned, what is the maqsood? An takrahu, aw tajida tilawatu, aw takun min al aqra al Quran. La. The intent is not that the person really reads it. He reads the Quran. And he beautifies its recitation. Or he's from those that says, Aqra al Quran. I'm the one that from those that read the Quran. Rab, alaykin inna ma yanfa'uk idha amalta bihi. Rather, it benefits you if you act upon it. And the majority of the tilawa, the mere just recitation of it, is not something that can be regarded as something that is beneficial. And so, whilst we're in this blessed month of Ramadan, the month where we should increase the recitation of the Quran, and be from those that benefit from our recitation of the Book of Allah, and strive to complete the recitation of the Book of Allah. When we read the example of the Salaf al-Salih and their recitation, and how they would conclude the recitation of the Quran, it's something we should strive to emulate. An example of that is the example of Qatada, rahimahullah, one of Salaf of this Ummah, where it mentioned that he would conclude the recitation of the Quran outside the month of Ramadan every 7 days. Whilst within the month of Ramadan, he would conclude every 3 days. And so thus, this is an example of that. Likewise, Imam Bukhari, where he mentioned that he would conclude the recitation of the Quran every day within the month of Ramadan. And so we should be from those that strive to recite from the Book of Allah. We not only recite, but recite and act upon it. That we're the individuals that act upon those ayat. And so thus those ayat are a means of benefiting us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Wa naqtafi. Wa hadha qadr barakallahu feekum wa jazakum ala khayra. Wa sallallahu wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.